Three, two, one.
Hello, Emily?
Yeah?
About the whole smelling thing, I meant to say that you smelled nice.
Every time I see you in the world, you always step to my girl.
This is Andrew Reid. He's an actor, director, and more importantly, my best friend. On top of that, he is majoring in theater for writing with having over 60 unfinished scripts. This is not a fictional film. This is a documentary on my best friend.
Can you do a quick clap for me?
Clap?
Yeah. Thanks.
Yep.
Okay.
When you say, like, what I do, do you mean, like...
What's your major in...
Okay, so I'm a senior theater major at George Mason University, BFA in dramaturgy and writing for the stage and screen.
Home was all we'd known. Father's feeling...
I have an older brother who's a professional actor in the DC area. I have a younger brother who is musically gifted and drumline captain at high school, and he's gonna go off to do things. And my mom is a piano teacher and was a world-renowned pianist who won championships and everything. And my dad is also experienced in producing and helping out with the arts. So I always felt like growing up that I was almost obligated to do something within the arts. I think why I love writing so much is because writing is the way to capture human experience in a form that uses language. The very core of it is you learn your language, you put a pencil in someone's hand, and anyone can write. That doesn't necessarily mean it's going to be good, but anyone can do it. A child's poem can have more meaning than someone's novel that they wrote for whatever the nano... November writing month is. So that's why I don't know, that's why I like writing. It's basic, it's simple, but it has a profound effect on, I think, millions of people.
I was playing video games since I was like 5 or 6. First console was Super Nintendo. I really discovered that games are more than just mindless fun. Games are an art form. I think in the next 5-10 years, I think people are gonna realize that video games are right up there with drawing, painting, film, theater. Putting the controller in someone's hand and bringing them into the story has such a profound impact. If I can write something as profound as The Last of Us, in my lifetime, then I will be satisfied. I will be happy. When I see games that write stories like that, I'm fascinated by their ability to make me cry as a gamer. Like, I'm playing a video game, and you don't associate emotional feelings with a video game normally. But when I stayed up till 5 in the morning playing The Last of Us for 9 hours straight because I didn't even realize I was so immersed in the game. And then I'm finished and I'm like tears rolling down my face. And I'm like thinking to myself, oh my God, like, did this game really just make me cry because I'm so attached to the characters and I'm so invested in the story? To be able to now be in a generation where writing is slowly becoming a art form within video games is very exciting for me personally, because I get to do two things that I love, and I get to create something that maybe someday people will play.
Tell me about Jess.
Oh, Jess.
So...
Jessica Reingold, age 21, height 4'9". I actually don't know if that's her height. It's like 5'1", maybe? She's short.
1, 2, 3, 4.
What's this?
The birth certificate for that.
Oh, that's weird.
You named it after yourself.
Yeah, I did.
When did you guys date?
Senior year.
Yeah.
Senior year of high school.
Yeah, it was senior year, yeah.
It was 8 months.
About a year.
8 months.
About a year. So towards the end of our relationship, it dawned on me that, to me personally, our relationship felt much more like a brother-sister relationship instead of a kind of romantic one.
I realized, like, right after he broke up with me that I wasn't initially super upset with the fact that, like, I'd lost a boyfriend. It was more the fact that I'd lost someone that I talked to every day.
She shaped me to be kind of the outgoing and honest, straight person that I am because she is such an honest person. And I'm thankful for her for doing that and showing me that it's like, it's okay, like it's good to be honest, not only to other people, but it's good to be honest to yourself and realize what it is that you want in life and not be afraid to go for it.
Wait, it's not that time.
No, it's not centered. Well, maybe your neck's not centered.
My neck can't be. Can you center it for
me? Ow!
Actually, I have a really funny story. Last year, Matt, we were at Starbucks and we were talking about Funyuns.
Last year, we were very like restrictive with like who's allowed in, who's allowed in, because a lot of people aren't really respectful to our room, right? But Andrew, he hasn't really asked, but we would find him just kind of on our couch or like eating there, and it was like completely okay. We cleaned up after himself, so it made us realize like there are some people that we can definitely trust.
He actually brought me a huge bag of Funyuns one day because I was craving them and I couldn't get them
because
anywhere.
Because no one craves Funyuns.
They were delicious.
I think we have like similar senses of humor, and he's really smart when he talks about like playwriting and sends us scripts, and I think he's very intelligent, so I go to him for advice with analyzing scripts and plays and seeing theater in a new way.
For me, it was working on the 10-Minute Play Festival, and he was my playwright and I was the director, and we got the chance to get really close really fast. And after rehearsals and auditions and stuff, we would go to Starbucks and we would talk about what we need to for about 15 minutes, and then spend the next 2 hours just talking.
Andrew's a very unique guy, a very specific style, and a very specific style of writing. Although I think my favorite moment with Andrew is the moment where I saw his 10-Minute Play Festival, which was completely off the wall different than the rest of the things he's made.
The kind of guy that you're like okay snuggling with like 4 a.m. Like it's a platonic thing, but then you're like, is it platonic? But you're too tired because it's too cute.
He made me a better person because I realized that I can't push people as hard as I thought I could. In terms of opening up or sharing things. In 10 years, I see him writing for a TV show.
Probably see him just chilling in a video store, a Blu-ray store, like recommending Blu-rays to people. He had like a nice like red streak of hair. People would be like, Andrew Jello. He's like, yeah, man, call me Jello. And
he'd probably be suffocating in his house in an episode of Hoarders underneath a whole like pile of skinny jeans, suspenders, and bow ties.
I really see him pushing artistic boundaries and creating really great works of theater or film and working with really inspiring, passionate people.
With really great bow ties and suit jackets and shoes. That's where Andrew is in 10 years.
Anything that I can do to make other people happy will make me happy. So far, I think I'm doing a pretty good job of it. At least, I hope. I don't know. I don't know if other people are happy, but let's assume that they are. And that makes me happy. Ideally, though, I would want to write a script that makes people smile. That would be cool.